And okay, it's recording now. One of the things that people have a problem with is in notation. When we've been doing kinematic equations, we've been having things like V final equals V initial plus acceleration times change in time. And delta x, which is displacement, is equal to the initial velocity multiplied by time plus 1/2 the acceleration multiplied by our time duration squared. And technically, this is supposed to have a delta on it, but I'm lazy and forget those sometimes. Okay. Our way of writing it, or at least my way of writing it, and also flipping physics. And we have the book rendition of things, which is also on the AP equation sheet. So it is, I like this way because it is explicit about when is it final, when is it initial, and it is explicit about finding displacement and not position. Okay, their way of writing it is that we are going to find the velocity v when we started off at some initial velocity at which point we hit the zero mark on our stopwatch. Our stopwatch started at zero. T initial was zero. Okay, by the definition of doing it this way. And acceleration looks the same. But then the t just is called t, right? Because this is the later time. This is, in reality, t final minus t initial, where initial was zero. Well, most of the time, that's the same thing we deal over here with the delta t. Almost, pretty much never do we tell you that at 12, 15, and 32 seconds, we started the event, and at 12, 18, and 17 seconds, it stopped. No, we give you a duration, okay? So there's some argument for this. The other thing that they do, which I hate, is that they break the displacement into initial and final position. And so they say that x is equal to x naught, which if you were to subtract x naught to the other side, I'm not done writing it out, but if we subtracted x naught to the other side, you'd have x, which is the final position, minus x naught, which is the initial position. X sub 0 is referred to as x naught. The term naught meaning 0 is a British thing, and I don't know, it caught on in physics. All right. So they write it as x equals x naught plus the v naught multiplied by t plus 1/2 the acceleration times t squared. That doesn't look very much different. Okay, you should be able to jump back and forth between these things pretty easily. We had our v final squared equals v initial squared plus 2 times our acceleration times our displacement. Their version of things pretty much looks the same, only it's v instead of v final. And it's v naught instead of v initial. And 2 times the acceleration. And then they split that thing up again. X minus x naught for the position and or displacement. Position initial, position final, combine their displacement. The last one was the one with the averages. Our displacement is equal to our average velocity. V final plus V initial multiplied by our time duration. Their version of it looks pretty much the same, except again, they're going to split out the positions. And V final is going to be V, and V initial is going to be V naught. And they're just putting T over here. For that guy. All right, so the way we've been writing it down so far, the way the book writes it down, people go and look things up and then they're totally confused on what the little zeros mean. Okay? They are the initial values back when you hit zero on your stopwatch.